to that lavender dreams. Deep down that river down to New Orleans, there'll be a band there to meet us. And old friends to greet us.
This is Jacob Moore, and I am the great nephew of Russell Moore. Russell Moore is a jazz musician, and he played with Louis Armstrong and had quite a career in jazz. And what is odd about that is that Russell Moore was a full-blood Pima who came from the Gila River Reservation and in southern Arizona. And when he was a young man, he was sent back to Chicago to live with his uncle. And his uncle was a jazz musician. Russell, in that home, learned to play music. She played classical music and gave lessons, and he played in the military band, so they grew up in this environment of music. Russell was so entranced with music, particularly jazz, that he used to hang outside the clubs in Chicago before he was old enough to get in. He ended up going to California to the Sherman Indian School and went to school there, and ended up playing with a jazz band in California, and ultimately worked his way back to Chicago and ended up playing with Louis Armstrong when he was in his late 20s, early 30s. He played off and on with Louis Armstrong over the years, and in the 1960s, when Louis Armstrong cut the Hello Dolly album, Russell Moore played on that album. My understanding was that the Hello Dolly album was number one on the charts, and it was knocked off by the Beatles, who at that time was just coming to the United States. On the B-side of the Hello Dolly album, Russell Moore has a solo on there. And Louis introduces that solo by saying, "Take it, Chief, take it, Chief, take it, Big Chief." His wife, Ida, she went to New York as a young lady to become an actress. And that's where she met Russell, and he showed her the nightlife in New York and introduced her. And within a month, they were married from when they first met. He had his own band in Paris in the late 30s. She said that it was always a surprise that they were in Paris for a show or a gig, and they were sitting in the airport, and she was looking down, and somebody walked up and they said, "Big Chief, when did you get into town?" And it was Frank Sinatra. And she wasn't even aware that he knew Frank Sinatra. On another occasion, she was saying that he was down in playing with Louis Armstrong's band in the South during the Jim Crow era, and that the story was that some soldiers came up to some military white guys who were at the show, came up to Russell during the break in the show and said, "What are you doing playing with these?" And they used the N-word, and that Russell said, "Come back after the show and I'll tell you." And the way the story was told is that a chance to respond, Russell started throwing blows with these guys and got into a fight with them and got thrown into jail, that Louis Armstrong had to bail him out. But the story is that this got back to Harlem. At that time it was in its heyday, and that before they came back from tour, and that when Russell Moore came back to New York, that he was treated like royalty in Harlem because he earned a reputation among all of the blacks and the musicians and the clubs in Harlem for fighting on behalf of blacks down in the South. And the rest of the story was that Nipsey Russell had a club in Harlem, and that whenever Russell walked in the club, Nipsey would always announce him and say, "Russell Moore has entered the building," and always got the royal treatment. So it's always it's interesting to imagine a Pima from southern Arizona who became a jazz musician who demanded such respect and earned such respect in Harlem during the heyday of jazz in that era, and also to have the ability to play with such outstanding musicians as someone like Louis Armstrong and Sammy Davis Jr. and a number of people that he developed his relationships and his career with over the years.
Ain't you glad you came with me? Down that crooked old Mississippi. Baby, that's where the dark and the night folks meet. Heaven on earth, they call it Basin Street.